Hi, I'm Wade from Thoroughbred Diesel, and today we're going to be showing you how to reseal a 7.3 liter Ford Powerstroke fuel bowl. Today we're resealing our fuel bowl for our 2001 Excursion. Now this is going to be tied into our video on replacing your high pressure oil pump, and we will link you to that somewhere in this video here. Now today we're going to be resealing our fuel bowl with Alliant Power's kit. This is Alliant Power AP0007. This works for the 99 to 2003 7.3 Powerstroke trucks. Leaking fuel bowl on the Powerstrokes is a very, very common thing. So we're going to show you how to redo this. The cool thing about this Alliant Power kit is it also comes with the grommets for the fuel lines inside the vehicle, and we will show you how to change those as well. We're going to show you what O-rings come in the Alliant Power fuel bowl reseal kit here. So what you get in the kit. So first off, you get your fuel, the grommets for the fuel lines. These are large square grommets. You'll know them as soon as you see them. There are four of them. These actually go on the fuel lines in the truck, and we will show you that here in just a minute. Then the large O-ring in the kit, this is for the fuel pressure regulator. The two large donut O-rings, these are for the fuel drain valve. The similar donut style O-rings, those are for the fuel heater itself. They are two different sizes. And then you have two same size O-rings, and they are much thinner and much smaller. These are for your fuel plugs or your test ports on the fuel bowl. Setting up to do our fuel bowl reseal kit, what I like to do before I even get started with this is I like to take a bristle brush and I like to go around the things that I'm going to be working on, most especially the fuel regulator right here. I like to get all the loose dirt off of that, and what that does is that's just it takes away any possibility of getting any contaminants in the bowl or anything like that to be picked up and processed by the fuel system, which is something that you don't want. So we'll pull my tray over here. When I start on the bowl, what I like to do is I like to turn it. Let me get it in the shot there. I like to turn it with the fuel heater, the fuel drain, and these two valves up. So, because that's what we're going to start with. And your sizes here, T15, T20, T25, and T30. You can use the Torxes on your Allen head bolts at the regulator as well. The regulators. Torx. I can't remember what's out. Oh, the plugs are out. Okay. All right. So first off, let's do the fuel heater. The fuel heater is going to be T20s. So we're going to go ahead and remove it. There is a wire on the fuel heater that is attached to the fuel heater element inside of the bowl, obviously. So when you pull the fuel heater out, when you pull the fuel heater wire connector out, you're going to want to be very careful with it. Don't just pull it out all the way and pull the wire loose, so you can see how that wire is attached right there. All right, so you just simply take it off of the spade on the electrical connector, and then you can see on the fuel heater itself, it's got a green and a red, if this has never been done before, O-ring. So we just want to go ahead and pull those off. All right, now these new O-rings are pretty tight, so what you want to do is you want to put a little bit of grease on them to get started there. The large one goes top, and it goes where the wire connector is. So you just want to clear that. And then you have your larger one at the bottom. And remember, these are the donut looking gaskets. You want to make sure that you get the right gasket here, because you can, for the top larger one, you can grab one of the donuts for the fuel drain valve, one of these washers, and it will not work. Will not work. All right, so we've got those seals in. We just want to take our electrical connector, put it back on that spade. We've greased it up good. So we're going to go ahead and push our fuel heater back in. When you're pushing on it, you want to be very careful that you don't break anything, but you want to go straight. When you go straight and you're not canted on the element or on the O-rings, then you have a lot less chance of tearing them. So we'll just put our screws back in, and I'm not going to take up time by tightening them down. I'll go through that in just a second. So now let's go ahead and do the fuel drain. This is the reseal for it. So this is the same size. So we'll remove these four bolts. Our fuel drain pop right out. Now it has got a standard in the top of the bowl right there, so you can see how I kind of pulled down on it to get that out. So you just want to watch that. Now if you see any contaminants inside of this, you want to try to remove those as well. And I'll pop this out real quick after I get that done. I want to set that down. The surface where they mount, I like to clean that up. There'll be a little bit of residual from those O-rings right there. And if you don't get it cleaned up, won't make a good seal for you. Okay. All right. Now, with both of those good, we want to get our two larger donut O-rings there. And just fooling with our fuel valve here, our drain valve, we're going to go ahead and insert those right where your two other yellow ones came out, right there. Then we will give it a little grease, like so. And then when you go back in, you want to make sure that you want to start downward to where the lever gets lined up the way it should. And then you want to be lined up with your standards. And this is going to be sealing against a flat surface there, recessed inside of the drain valve itself. So we want to start all of our bolts. And then when we are tightening this down, we're going to do so in a crisscross manner. Grab the wrong size. Get everything started there before I seat it. And when I'm tightening it down, again, I'm going crisscross. I want to make sure that the drain valve itself is actually flush against the bottom of the fuel bowl. So tighten those two down. Go ahead and do that. Then make sure that my drain valve still works and it's free, and it does. So we'll close it off. Now we're going to go ahead and do our two test ports plugs on here. Seal those. They are the T30s. They're actually Allen's, but I've got the Torx's here that will work for it. Golly. Well, really wanted to make sure that one didn't come out. All right. Pull that plug, and then pull this plug. And they're both the same size, so we're just going to roll the old O-rings off. This is another one of these where I walked away from the bench and I didn't bring or walked away from my toolbox. And how do you do a fuel valve reseal kit and you don't bring your picks with you? I don't know the answer to that. Pocket knife gets her done again, boys. All right. Put our two O-rings on there that come in our Alliant Power kit. They're the thinner O-rings that you get. A little grease for them too. All right, we're at our fuel pressure regulator side now. The fuel pressure regulator is located right here. It's got two T25 Torx bolts that hold it in. Now, when you're removing the regulator, it is spring loaded. So you want to take your, remove the bolts one at a time, or not one at a time, alternate between the two. And I like to keep my hand on the cap on the regulator. And I mean, it's got a pretty good amount of spring tension in here. So when it's ready to go, it's ready to go. Well, you want to go ahead and remove these two screws. All right. And you got your cap. And this is the seal that we're going after, is this one inside of here. So what we'll do is, during our little break there, I made it over to my box and got my handy dandy pick. So we'll just roll this O-ring out. Ready? Then we're going to reinstall the last O-ring there from Alliant Power. And we'll go ahead and get it inside of here. And I like to put a little grease on it just to help it seal up. Okay. Also, I'll clean around this just a little bit so we have a good sealing surface. And if it comes apart on you, your regulator's got the spring and the plastic insert like that. And then there is a another part to the regulator here that's down in the barrel. It doesn't need to come out, but if it does, this is the assembly, how it goes right there. And that just goes back in. Got a seal on the bottom of it. So we'll put that back in, and then we're going to put our regulator cap back on. Just go ahead and get it started down. You want to make sure that spring centers up in the middle. Okay. And then we want to go ahead and tighten it down. Make sure you alternate between the screws so you can take this down evenly and correctly. And then on either side of this regulator cap, as soon as I get this down here, on these opposite corners of the regulator cap, it's got a couple of little locating pins there for the cap. So make sure that before you start tightening this too tight, that those locating pins are where they're supposed to be. You can look at that, make sure it's flush. If it's flush, you're in good shape. And then we will snug it down like so. All right, voila. There is our fuel bowl resealed, ready to go back in the truck. Now all we have to do is do our fuel line grommets. All right, we're gonna do our final piece to the resealing the fuel bowl puzzle, and we're going to be putting in our fuel line grommets. Now there are three sizes of grommets for the four lines. The two fuel feed lines going to the heads,
to each individual head. They are the smaller grommets. So I'm gonna pull those out here. And then your fuel into the bowl, your fuel supply, is the largest grommet. And then your fuel return is the next to largest grommet. So I've got those two right here. So let me show you how to change these real quick. And I'm going to use this fuel return because this is closest to Adam's camera, and it shows you what you look at with these seals. So when you take the fuel bowl off, you're going to have these seals, after they get old, they're going to start coming apart. Okay, now there's still a lot of seal left here, but once you've got that kind of deterioration, you're on your way to a leak, because this rubber's getting more brittle, it's getting hollower in some sides. So we're just gonna go ahead and pull this off. So yes, this is a flared end, but to roll the seals off, you just pull them off like so, okay? I'm going to just clean this up kind of with my hands here and this rag just a little bit. And what I like to do, keep a little bit of lube, keep a little lube with me here. Always got it on me. And put that on the pipe. And I have got to find my next largest seal. So we go ahead and now these seals are very good quality. So they're not gonna just fall on to the line. So whatever you do with the fuel lines, you're gonna wanna make sure you support it on the backside, because you don't want to be shoving on these seals and being aligned. All right. Just got to keep working with it. So you'll know that you've gotten everything out of the seal if you can take it, or out of the cap if you can take it and turn it, and it's pretty free. So that's got that one done. And just remember, just kind of support the lines as you go back and you're putting these new seals on, because you are going to be putting quite a bit of pressure on them to get the old seals off. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to put all of our other seals on, and we're not going to bore you with that, but you make sure that you get them on all four lines, again, three different sizes. So this is how to reseal a 7.3 fuel bowl, 99 to 2003 trucks. If you have a question about this installation video or any of our other installation videos, just let us know. This is tied in with our replacing a 7.3 high pressure oil pump video. We will link you to that in this video. We will also link you to the page where you can purchase the fuel filter drain valve kit from Alliant Power, part number AP0007. Thank you for watching.